I'm Sarah the gardener, and it's exciting times. Oh my gosh, I am going to move my temporary garden to a temporary spot temporarily. This is great news. What this means is that it is time to get started on the garden. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Now the reason I need to move it is the container that's it's leaning up against, that it's supporting from the wind, and the wind that comes from the coast anyway, not this one, it's going. So it has all our worldly possessions in it, but now we're in a position where we can actually move things out of it and somewhere else. And so what that will do is free up the space for my garden, because this is where I want to put it, and there's a shipping container right there. So I'm going to move some things, but before I do that, I have some kumara, which is in the flower pots over there, and they need to come out, and also some yams. It's the time to dig them up. So let's just get on with that, because there's a lot to do. Right, come and join me. Come on, come on, come on. Okay, well, I'm not expecting a lot, because I never get a lot. I think our climate's not quite right. I don't think it's cold enough, but it doesn't stop me trying, and so this must be attempt number 6. I don't know. There'll be a 7, I know that. The key is to wait till it's all died down, and I think I can safely say that's died down, because even in those last few dying stems, is taking nutrients back down into the yams. If you don't know what yams are, they're like, they're also called ochre, we call them yams. And it's good to grow it in a container or something like that, because if you don't get every last little one, it's like potatoes, but worse. So I don't know if anyone's got oxalis in their gardens. It's related to that, so you don't really want too much. Right, okay, well, I can see straight away that we do have some. So they're easy to find because they're pink. Right, let's hope we get some big ones. This is probably the worst harvest ever. Maybe if I grow them from scratch in this new location, they'll be better. Well, that was a waste of time. Right, I've got one more. Maybe this one will be better. That's my best one. Do you know who? I put in 6 seed ones that were twice the size of this. Would have done better just to eat the ones that I planted. But never mind. It's a challenge. Next year, I will do better. Right. Okay. Okay, so this might be a bit breezy, but let's get these sweet potatoes out of the container, see what we have. Hopefully it's better than the yams. Oh my gosh. These have been in since early October, I think. Sorry. They've been in a while. You normally have to wait for the frost to die down, now the frost to take the foliage, have them all die down. We haven't had a frost, but other people have, so now's as good a time as any. Oh. I hope that's not an example. Oh! Right, one. Right, here we go. Slips when in here. So slips are when you get one of your kumaras and you put it in a jar of water, toothpicks to hold it in place, and the roots come out the bottom and the shoots come out the top, and then you end up with like shoots that you can, and it roots. So then you, oh there we go, look. You take, so that would have been if I hadn't snapped it. So then you put that in a jar of water, roots come out, and then you plant that when it's about this size. So there's also a trick that if you plant it in a L shape, so when you plant your slip, you plant it with the root like that, so that it doesn't run to ground and then have just long thin roots. But I think that is one. Right. Oop. Quite impressed. One more to go. Right. That I don't need to move to the temporary location temporarily. But the yam harvest may suck. I'll eat them anyway. I grew it, I'll eat it. But that's not to be sneezed at. That's not bad. I mean, in open ground in the right conditions, probably get more. But I'm happy with that. Temporarily grew it in the middle of moving house, so that's something to be proud of. Right, now I'm gonna start moving stuff. Oh my gosh, where do I begin? Right, here we go. stuff anyway. There's still the big stuff like the lemons and the lime and the big pots, but I'm exhausted. So I'm going to get help with the young gardener to move those for me, and I'm going to go and have a well-deserved cup of tea. So thanks so much for watching. Come again next time, because things are obviously afoot. Progress is being made. And so we'll see you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.